Hello, my friend. Today we are going on our series about international commercial terms, or we can say Incoterms 2020, and we will learn each of rules one by one. And let's look what we learned today.
Today I would like to talk to you about Carriage and Insurance Paid To. Incoterms has 11 kinds of trade rules, and Carriage and Insurance Paid To means that the seller delivers the goods to the carrier or another person nominated by the seller at an agreed place. If any such place is agreed between the parties and that the seller must contract for and pay the costs of carriage necessary to bring the goods to the named place of destination.
Hey, my name is Murat. Welcome to my channel, where I help you start and grow your international business, make more money, save more time, and help more people too. If you are new here or haven't subscribed yet, so make sure to subscribe to my channel and turn on the notification for more great quality content on the import and export business and change your life. So make sure thumbs up to this video here on YouTube. It helps the video to reach more people. Thanks again, let's get started.
My video is divided into 6 sections. To begin with the definition of Incoterm Carriage and Insurance Paid To, following that I will give you an explanation of the CIP term. Next, I am going to talk about what are the buyer's and seller's responsibilities with the Carriage and Insurance Paid To agreement. Then I will give you CIP tips and tricks. And finally, I will give my advice. By the end of the video, you will know Carriage and Insurance Paid To well and understand how CIP works.
Okay, let's start with the definition of Incoterm Carriage and Insurance Paid To. CIP means that the seller is responsible for delivery costs, and insurance costs of the goods until they are transferred to the first carrier tasked with transporting the goods. Once this delivery takes place, the buyer takes on all responsibility. If you are considering shipping using CIP, make sure to read the details of your contract carefully. This Incoterm is recommended only if you are using a letter of credit. So, that completes the definition of Incoterms Carriage and Insurance Paid To. Let's move on to an explanation of the CIP term. In Carriage and Insurance Paid To, the seller assumes all risks until the goods are delivered to the first carrier at the place of shipment, not place of destination. Once the goods are delivered to the first carrier, the buyer is responsible for all risks. However, the seller is responsible for the cost of carriage as well as risk insurance coverage until the freight reaches the named place of destination. A carrier is any person or company who undertakes the carriage of goods, such as shipping line, airline, trucking company, railway, or freight forwarder. In multimodal shipments, the place of shipment is the first carrier used. Same as CPT, but the seller is obligated to secure all risk insurance coverage.
Right, so now we have come to the seller's and buyer's responsibilities in a CIP transaction. Let's explore the seller's responsibilities under a Carriage and Insurance Paid To agreement. Under the CIP Incoterm, the seller is responsible for the following requirements. Export packaging. The seller is required to package the products sold in transport-worthy export packaging. Loading charges. In the event of charges incurred while cargo is loaded onto a truck at the seller's warehouse, it is the seller's responsibility. Delivery to port or place. The seller is responsible for all costs associated with transporting the loaded goods to the port or place of export. Origin terminal handling charges. Also known as OTHC, the seller must cover these costs at the origin terminal. Loading on carriage. The cost to load the cargo onto the carriage is the seller's responsibility. Freight charges. These are the shipping charges which are to be paid by the seller. Insurance. The seller is responsible for arrange and pay for the insurance to cover the buyer's risk. Destination terminal handling charges, also known as DTHC, the seller must also cover these costs at the destination terminal. Export duty, taxes and customs clearance. The costs and responsibilities associated with formally exporting the cargo from the origin country.
The buyer and seller must understand that in a CIP transaction, the risk passes from the seller to buyer once the seller delivers the cargo to the first carrier, whereas the costs up to the named destination will still be for the seller. Because the CIP term may be used for all modes of transport, the movement could involve a road, rail, and sea movement. This means there are three carriers involved here. In CIP, once the seller hands over the goods to the road carrier for further movement, the risk transfers from the seller to the buyer, but the cost of the movement till the point of destination remains with the seller.
Okay, let's discover the buyer's responsibilities in a CIP transaction. The buyer is responsible for the following stages when purchasing under CIP Incoterms.
Delivery to destination. Once the cargo unloads from the carrier, the buyer is responsible for paying to deliver the cargo to their final desired destination.
Unloading at destination. At times, there are unloading fees at warehouses when cargo arrives. If any expenses are incurred, it is the buyer's responsibility to cover these charges.
Import duty, taxes, and customs clearance. The buyer shall pay all import fees. This includes customs examinations, damage, penalties, or holding charges.
In CIP, since the contract of carriage is arranged by the sellers at his expense, it is normal for the seller to use his service contract and also prepay the cost of the freight up to the destination.
Okay, I have explained what are the buyer's and seller's responsibilities with the carriage and insurance paid to agreement. Now I would like to discuss CIP tips and tricks.
By contrast, this Incoterm is often an excellent choice for larger importers. If they have an agent responsible for goods clearing and delivery, once they reach the terminal at the importing country, if there is more than one carriage in the export country, example via a forwarder's warehouse for consolidation, the seller is not responsible for the middleman, unless that is made clear in the sales contract.
Risk and responsibility are handed over at different points for C terms.
Risk is transferred in the export country when the carrier received the shipment, even though the buyer has booked and paid for the main carriage.
Be sure to specify the name of place delivery elsewhere in the sales contract.
The seller is required only to arrange minimum insurance cover to the invoice value of the goods. If the buyer does not consider that coverage sufficient, an agreed level of cover can be included elsewhere in the contract of sale.
Although the seller is responsible for insurance, the risk transfers to the buyer before the main carriage.
The seller is not obliged to arrange insurance for pre-carriage in the export country or carriage in the importing country unless this is specified elsewhere in the sales contract.
Okay, I have explained CIP tips and tricks. Now I would like to give my advice on a CIP transaction.
As with all Incoterms, the point of delivery must be expressly discussed and agreed upon between the buyer and the seller. When using the CIP term, this point becomes all more important as the risk and cost transfers at different points. And if this is not understood, it could cause penalties and additional costs to the buyer or seller.
In CIP terms, while the buyer might enjoy the benefits of the insurance cover secured by the seller, the buyer must also be aware that in CIP terms, the seller is only obliged to take minimum insurance coverage to cover the buyer's risk, irrespective of whether the risk has passed from the seller to the buyer or not. The buyer needs to ensure that the goods are fully and properly insured, as that the buyer's obligation under CIP.
That brings me to the end of my video. I hope you are a little clearer on Incoterms Carriage and Insurance Paid Too. Thank you very much for being here.
Next videos in this series, I will share with you the Incoterms 2020 rules one by one.
And if you want to learn more detailed about the Incoterms 2020 rules, please do not forget to subscribe to my channel and turn on the notification. I have some good stuff over here you can watch and learn more about international trade and business. Keep going. Take care. Bye.